morning and welcome back to the Breakfast Club. And as mentioned earlier, we have a very special guest. She's none other than Phillipa Yoong.
Good morning.
Good morning, Phillipa. How are you today?
I'm very well, thank you.
Is it an early day for you?
It's very early.
Well, Phillipa is here to talk about her recent win at the SEA Games, recent gold medal that you won with your brother, which needs no introduction, Alex Yoong, and your sister, the very young and talented Alia Yoong. But first of all, maybe perhaps just tell the viewers just a little bit about yourself. What do you do and how did you get started in the sports?
Okay, I'm 33 years old now, but I started skiing when I was 10.
Okay.
Together with my brother. We used to go to Balakong, which is now the mines. Back then it was like this big pit, you know, it's like 500 feet deep. It's an amazing, amazing sight, very, very deep. So we started there, and then my dad soon started his own business in Tamandesa. And my brother and I were there every day after school, Christmas, Chinese New Year, you know, just helping out, driving the boat.
And how did you actually get into water ski? Were you like watching television and then you got interested in the sport? So how did the interest start?
My dad actually was always interested ever since he was young, and he tried in Port Dickson. You know, you just get a piece of wood and you go behind the outboard and go and ski. So when we were older, he decided, hey, I've got the money, I've got the time, I've got the kids, why not bring everyone there?
So it's very encouraging and supportive.
Yeah. So the whole family did it, and they still do it. Now my dad has three more kids.
Okay.
Alia is my half-sister, and then I've got two more half-brothers. And it's really a family sport, you know, the whole family can enjoy it, from young to old.
You know, when people think about water ski, they actually have to go somewhere far away. To a beach and all that.
Yeah.
But what if you're in KL and you're living in Selangor area? You were mentioning about the mines and all that. You can actually water ski there.
Yeah. There's actually three venues.
Okay.
Mines, Puchong, which I'm not sure if they're still running, and Putrajaya.
Okay.
And I know I'm biased, but definitely Putrajaya is the best because this is Putrajaya, and it's the water so clean, the infrastructure is amazing, the Pusat Maritime, and then the Pullman is right there. I mean, everybody who comes say it's a world-class venue.
And just now you mentioned that you started water skiing at 10 years old, but at what age did you start to enter it as a competitive sport?
Oh, straight away.
Okay, at 10?
Yeah.
Okay.
So
you're just fast, you just managed to grab the sport.
Well, no, there's levels, right? So first you enter novice, and then you enter intermediate, and then expert, and then open.
That's right.
So my dad is actually a really amazing event organizer, so he organized really great tournaments called like the Asian Championships, and then at that time it was the Kent Championships, and then we had the Asian Australasians.
Okay.
So I mean, you always start young and you always start slow, and then you build up to it until you get to the world level or Asian level. So yeah,
We're here also to talk about your recent win at the SEA Games. But this is actually not, before we talk about your medals and all your success here, this is not actually your first game, right? You actually have competed and represented Malaysia previously in the SEA Games. When was that? When was your first game?
That was in 97.
Okay.
So you can see my age already. So 97, I won gold for jump.
Okay.
And then I got two bronze.
Okay.
So to come back, to have like a 10-15 year break and then come back in 2008-2009, after having two kids, really... You know, I can feel the difference. Like, my body is different. My mind is different. My kids are amazing. You know, my husband's amazing. Thank goodness. Otherwise, I can't do this.
Okay.
So, I've had the privilege and the honor of representing Malaysia around the world. So, we've been to Japan. We've been to England. We've been to Australia. So this year I did the Asians in October, and I got gold medal for that. And then in November, just the next month, that's why it was so hectic for me and I'm so tired. So November, SEA Games, I got two golds, one silver and one bronze.
Okay, so you were on quite a short hiatus before the SEA Games. So how was the preparations like for you before you entered the SEA Games, and was there any expectations when you entered the SEA Games?
Yes, definitely. Because I won the gold in 97, so everyone said you have to win a gold again, you know. And then my dad was saying, hey, how about two golds, you know? And then Alia, of course, was supposed to win gold for the women's tricks because she did really well on the Asians. So those two expectations, but my brother wasn't supposed to win anything at all.
That's a surprise.
Yeah, we just said, come on, just try, you know? I know you're racing and all that, and he's so busy with ESPN and going to England for Lotus. I really had to work hard. Me and my dad had to work hard to convince him to join. But once he joined, he trained a lot.
Okay.
And I don't know if you noticed, but he's lost a lot of weight. Have you seen him on ESPN lately?
I saw on ESPN. I saw on the picture in the newspaper as well. On the front cover.
he's lost so much weight because he's getting a bit unfit, you know.
Okay.
So yeah, so all of a sudden he won a gold and a silver, and we were just blown away. It was a really good performance.
Okay, and you also brought along your gold medal here on
yes.
the breakfast club.
Oh,
my medal. The silver and the bronze as well. Which competition did you win the gold for?
So I won gold in overall and slalom.
Okay.
There's three events for tournament skiing.
Okay.
There's slalom, which is side to side going around six boys.
Okay.
There's tricks, which is more like ballet, which is what Alia does,
okay.
which 540, 360, 720,
okay.
and flips and all that. And there's jump, which is purely distance.
Okay.
Yeah, so you maximum speed with a 5 foot ramp height, and then they measure the distance. So Alex is really good at jump.
Okay.
Really good at jump. So I won gold for overall and slalom, and
okay.
he won the gold for overall.
Okay.
Meaning he did all three events and he was the best.
Okay. That's also, you also took home the overall, so you actually, it was miscalculated on the different slalom, the different slalom here, tricks and jump.
Yeah.
And it was on average, and then you won the overall.
Yeah, because not many people do all three.
Okay.
People normally specialize, especially when they get to our age,
okay.
you know, like past 30, they normally specialize either slalom or trick or jump.
What about Alia? She's so young, 8 years old, and she's in the history books, I guess. She's the younger athlete. Both male or female to actually won the gold medal. So
yeah.
What about Alia at that age to actually win the gold medal and to be part of this, you know, adults, you know, they are in their 20s and 30s, that must be a huge victory
yeah,
for
yeah.
her.
I mean, we're trying to kind of manage her to make sure she doesn't have, you know, she's so young, you know, we don't want it to like affect her life.
Okay.
So we're trying to keep it, you know, but she's had so much exposure in the newspaper.
That's
people
right.
who come up to me, they don't even read the sports section because she's in the front section.
That's right.
So it's amazing. Like, we're all so proud of her, but she trains really hard. She trains almost every day, you know.
Does she really know how big this victory is for her? She's like, okay, it's just another gold medal, you know, I've done this for SEA Games. But does she really know that how big this
victory
is?
I think it's half-half.
Okay.
You know, because she's only eight.
Yeah.
So she kind of knows, but then she's back at school, she's got her friends,
okay,
you know.
She has a normal life,
yeah.
No, but she won a gold medal at the SEA Games.
Yeah.
But when you're mentioning like starting at 8 or 10 years old, is that the right age to actually start water ski as we move on to talk about, you know, water ski in Malaysia?
Yeah. You know, people in America, they start when they're 4 or 5, which is what Alia did.
Okay.
She started when she was 5. So if your dad owns a water ski business,
okay.
or if you live next to a lake, it's easy.
Okay.
It's easier. So because you're there all the time, and the sheer exposure to the sport, and then the coaches that my dad brings in, and the events that we have, of course something good is going to happen.
What about if you're starting like around your teens and you're like, okay, I saw Alia, you know, Phillipa and Alex in the newspaper, this is a cool event, water ski, I want to get into this at the age of, you know, in their teens or in their 20s, early 20s.
Possible, definitely possible. Because I started 10, 11,
okay.
and we have really, really amazing wakeboarders in Sarawak now,
okay.
and they're in their early 20s and they're doing amazingly well.
And if they want to actually play water ski in Malaysia, they actually go to Putrajaya, like what you mentioned
yes.
just now, right?
Come to Putrajaya. Seriously, anybody can do it. We will see how you go. Once the parents commit to the time and commit to the investment and their kids like it, if you do well and you have potential, the federation will sponsor, you know, or will find a way to sponsor you because we're always looking for more people.
And even as you entered the SEA Games, you were a coach as well, right?
Yeah.
So you actually coached the national team? Or?
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, there's a few of us.
Okay.
I coach, my dad coaches, and then also, like I said, he brings in these coaches from England, from America, from South America. So it's just nonstop, you know, because you have to. Like, it's expensive for us to go out to train, but it's cheaper to bring the coaches in here to Malaysia to train all of us. So,
okay.
you know, Triple WC is doing
so, like, you know, Alex, he's known so much as a Formula One driver, but you know, he's Formula One driver, he water skis. Do you actually play any other sports as well?
I try to play as many sports as I can because our family believes that a healthy lifestyle is a sporty outdoor lifestyle.
Okay.
So me and my husband, we used to go rock climbing, scuba diving.
Yeah,
but
a bit of everything.
But with two small kids, it's really difficult, you know. We have to tailor our lives around the kids.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, Phillipa, we're actually short of time. So how can our viewers connect with you if they want to keep in contact with you? Do you actually have a website? Are you on Twitter, Facebook?
Yes. My personal Facebook or the water ski Facebook, you just type in water ski Putrajaya or just go to waterski.com.my.
Are you on Twitter as well?
I am on Twitter, but I'm not really sure. I'm not really tech savvy.
No, you know what?
So
I actually saw her profile on Twitter. That was like 2 years ago.
Oh, no! And I haven't updated it. No, I have to. I'm gonna start.
Okay.
I'm gonna start Twitter.
Well, thank you so much for coming on our show to talk about your SEA Games, and congratulations to you for winning the gold medal for Malaysia, as well as congratulations to Alia and Alex.
And Alex,
we actually
wanted
Alia to come on the show as well.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
She has such a young and talented athlete there. But that's all the time that we have. Stay tuned for The Breakfast Club tomorrow, because it's Women Empowerment Day on Wednesday. So stay tuned, and thank you for watching. I'm Shafiq Shuim, and this is Phillipa Yoong.
Thank you.